In this lecture, I'll cover an interesting aspect of rotational motion, pure ruling, ruling with slipping, ruling without slipping. Ruling without slipping is pure ruling. Now, just the basics, and then I will cover the important aspect of ruling up the inclined plane. And there are interesting things there. Now, if you take, say, a sphere, here this is the velocity of center of mass, and this is omega. And I take a situation, suppose on this side I show velocity and omega r. And I take velocity of center of mass, in my case, is greater than omega r. V center of mass is greater than r omega. Is greater than r omega. Just if you look at the graph, it's very clear to understand. Ultimately, I'm saying pure ruling has to start. So this is the time. So pure ruling will start when only these two points meet. And they will not meet immediately. They take some time. The slipping takes time. So what is happening, you see? Velocity of center of mass is reducing. And omega r is increasing. So there is a force here which is acting against this, but which is acting along this. This is nothing but if you put the friction force like this, it will provide retarding acceleration to V center of mass and a torque which is equal to I alpha. So alpha will be F into R upon I. This will be the acceleration which will increase the omega R, and same force will provide retardation, or I can write it as minus F upon M. So on one side you have retardation for the linear motion and the acceleration for the angular motion, for the rotational motion, and you reach a situation where V is equal to R omega. This is pure ruling. Okay, now take another case. Here is the case where omega R is greater than V center of mass. And this is V center of mass. Just, it is easier to see it on such kind of graph. Just put omega R here, V center of mass here. They have to meet. Well, how they can meet? This has to reduce, this has to increase, and a pure ruling after time t. This is time, and this is the point of pure ruling. And this is also a point of pure ruling. After this time, the pure ruling starts. What's happening in this case? Omega r is going down. V center of mass is going up. So there is a force which is accelerating, which is helping it. So it is the friction force. And same force is providing torque, which is retarding it, which is equal to I alpha. I can write in negative because alpha will be its retardation. So torque is equal to F into R, and so FR is equal to minus I alpha. And here acceleration is F upon M. So you have acceleration on one side, retardation on the other side, and that is how after some point of time it reaches a pure ruling motion where V center of mass is equal to R omega. Now here, what is happening? Which side the slipping is taking place? When friction force is acting backwards, means I am slipping forward. That is why friction force is acting, my slipping will always be, my reference for slipping will be against the direction of friction force. So it is forward slipping. And here the friction force is acting forward. So I am being dragged actually. I am being dragged here. So it is the forward slipping. My center of mass is not having enough velocity, but my feet are moving very fast. So I am being like this. I am being pushed forward, and this friction force is working straight, helping me to move it. I am accelerating, but my feet are being retarded. Here it's a reverse. My speed is very fast. Center of mass, I'm moving very fast. Feet are not moving so fast. My feet are being pushed backward. So this way it is happening. Now, it's a very simple case. Pure ruling, once it starts, do you still need friction force? Can pure ruling happen on a frictionless surface? It can happen. If there is no distortion of the sphere and the point of contact is single, then you don't need any force to move it in the regular motion. If it has acquired a motion of V is equal to R omega, then you don't need friction force in case of a horizontal movement. But if in case the movement is not horizontal, in case, and you don't need force in ideal situations. Otherwise, you will need force because there is a distortion at the point of contact. I'm talking about theoretical position. Now, let us take a case where I am putting a body, and it is very interesting, on the inclined plane. Now, on the inclined plane, when I put the body, I give it omega as omega initial, and my u is zero. My velocity is zero, and omega is there. It has to move upwards. When it has to move upwards, there has to be a force which has to move it upwards. The gravity is pulling it backwards, mg sine theta. This is normal. And this is mg cos theta. So there has to be a force. It is slipping also. Because omega is greater than u. It's just like skidding, backward slipping. So it has to, the friction force is in this direction. And this force moves it up. It has to provide the acceleration and the retardation to omega. See, the situation here is like this. It is omega r and u is zero. So I have to reach a point. I want to reach a point where pure rolling starts. So I have to reach a point where pure rolling starts. This is pure rolling point. Hence, it will achieve some height here after some time. Now, what should be the required condition to move it upwards? I write it as F1, so or F. So F has to be greater than mu m mg sine theta, sorry. And here it is slipping, so F, you put static friction mu s mg cos theta has to be greater than mg sine theta. This has to be the condition for making it move upwards and reach a point where the pure rolling starts. Now, when it reaches here at the point of pure rolling, what will be the direction of friction force? It's an important question. What is the direction of friction force? If I take friction force still like this, I take it like this. Now, the net force acting on it is upward forces F minus mg sine theta. And the torque acting on it will retard its omega. Torque acting on it is also, sorry, if the friction force is like this, the torque acting on it, yes, torque acting on it is retarding it, right? Torque acting is against the rotation. Rotation is like this. I am here at this point. The friction force I am taking like this. Omega is like this. The torque is retarding it. So omega will fall. But this is the upward force. And we have taken initially, this has to be greater than mg sine theta. Doesn't it appear that you will have a net upward force? So instead of retarding, it should keep on accelerating. It should keep on moving upwards. What is the mistake here? What point I am missing? Just think over. If I am saying that friction force has to be like this, and I am writing upward force like this, and here I have taken this condition for upward movement. This was the condition for upward movement. Mu mg cos theta should be greater than mg sin theta. Now I write it as this. And I want it to be less. It should be negative. Otherwise, it will accelerate. It should be negative. Body has to retard. And I am saying it is not slipping also. It is pure rolling. So it has to be negative. And here I am saying mu mg cos theta is greater than mg sin theta. Where is the missing link? Where is the contradiction? Will the friction force be backwards? If the friction force is backwards, your omega will, if I say friction force is like this, your omega will accelerate. It will accelerate. But omega has to fall. It has to come to rest. Velocity has to fall. Omega has to fall. So how I deal with this riddle? On one side, I have taken this condition, but this seems to be the appropriate thing for me to come to a halt because my velocity also has to retard. This has to be negative. And the omega also has to come down. So this is the right condition. Is it contradicting? Does it contradict? Where is the missing link? Just think over. I'll cover it later on.